wrap it around your finger. Just the day you're born.
Oh, that's cool.
Beautiful baby from the outside in. Chase your dreams, but always know the road that'll lead you.
Welcome. Trying to center myself up, if you bear with me here. Well, I hope everyone out there is doing well today. And thank you all for coming. Today's the day, the biggest day of both of your lives up until this point. And I'd like to first start out by letting everyone here know that you guys are all witnessing this today, and you're responsible for one part or another in writing this story for you, Jarah. I've been truly blessed with this amazing honor and opportunity to be the first person to introduce these two who are a rather crazy and action-packed life that is now considered to be the new normal. Corey, Jarah, you two love making life interesting, don't you? Planning a wedding is said to be one of the most stressful things a young couple will ever endure. And you two decided to do it while the world was being dismantled. It's rather interesting, I'd say. But to me, I'd say that means something, and possibly something you two may have overlooked. So bear with me for a moment. I want you all to think of a time where the next few days are unknown. I want you to picture the location. Impromptu. But I want you to think of the time, picture a location, think about the anxiety, the time of day. Is it scary? Maybe it's hard to sleep. And I want you to think about how long that feeling lasted. Is it a few hours? A few days? A few weeks? Fast forward to today and ask yourself if you're still undergoing that same feeling of uncertainty and fear. For most, they can say that they've successfully managed it and were able to move on with their lives. For these two individuals, they've been living that scenario for the better part of 3 months now, and ever since such a burdening time, they both never once imagined going through it with anybody else. To me, that's powerful. It's impressive. Most of all, it's important. Mankind is formed and continues to make obstacles that will challenge you daily. Loops, hoops, dips, hurdles that you two will inevitably face will not be different forever. You take them as they come, one at a time if possible. And you overcome them as a unit, a team, or a family. During this planning process, I sat down with Corey and Jarah, and I tried to gather information as to what kind of ceremony they wanted to give, and let me tell you, the outline was rather open-ended, to say the least. You want me to say this? That's up to you. You think about this? That's your call. And are we going to do any of these? Well, what do you think? So, I was pretty stuck in the direction I wanted to take with this until I heard the one thing that I've been waiting to hear, and that's just, Devin, just don't make it all about yourself. So, at this point, I've prepared a small 45-minute monologue about my life, growing up in court, and how it makes me feel. It all started when I was three. Mom was kidding. Ephesians 4:32 says to be kind to one another, tenderhearted, forgive one another, as God in Christ forgave you. It's words to live by, to say the least. And I don't know 100% what you two have planned with your lives. But what I do know is it won't be perfect. And at times you need to remember kind, but remember you're not alone. When all else fails, remember there will always be someone on your side. And I encourage you to not be ashamed if you need help. Remember to ask for it. Ask often. Most spiritual individuals tell you, ask for the Lord's help. It's not in there. For knowledge is power. And with marriage, what better knowledge to have than the experience to those closest to you? I want you to keep in mind that every married man or woman here today is something more valuable than money to help you in the success of marriage. They have lived or are living through many of the same experiences you two will inevitably encounter throughout your lives together. Above all else, trust in yourselves and the Lord, and there will be nothing you two can't help. Today, you're getting married. Still letting that sink in a bit. But it's good to let things sink in. Enjoy the day. And believe me when I say, after this, life begins to fly. I wanted to share one thing about my personal experience of marriage and that you should take with you. That advice is to make your own path. In the weeks leading up to your wedding, people joke and poke fun, and leading up to my wedding, people joke and poke fun and told me not to, or don't get married because it's a trap, or it's considered the ring of change, you know? It's important to listen, but it's even more important to get rid of the negativity. My wife and I continue to laugh, smile, and love each other every day. And that should always be things that are high on your priority list. Remember that just because she's your wife or he's your husband, it doesn't have to be structured all the time. If nothing else, you're getting a legal document that says, hey, I want to be a little crazy and spontaneous, and you have to love me anyway for it. And Corey, not so young anymore, man. We made leaps and bounds in our lives. We've changed a lot. We grew up, reprioritized life. I think it's fair to say at some point, we both thought we'd end up with working with Dad, still mowing soccer fields and wiring up pool heaters. But I'm proud of you, man. For the first time in a long time, it seems like you're truly satisfied from where you're at. I guess we have Jarah to thank for that. Jarah, I'm excited to be welcoming you and your sister into the family. My mom's excited the number of women is increasing in the household. You're strong, you're independent, and you're fun. It's three things that make you perfect for dealing with my brother. You're truly welcomed addition to the family, and I know you two will make many happy memories throughout the years together. So, Jarah, would you mind repeating after me? I, Jarah Elizabeth Spar, Corey Michael Glace, to be my wedded husband, happy to hold this day forward, better for worst, the richer for poor, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish. Jarah, would you please place that ring on Corey's finger for me? Ready? I, Corey Michael Glace, and E. Jarah Elizabeth Spahn, be my wedded wife. Having to hold this this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish. Death is part. So, can you see I do? And I ask you to remember your commitment you two have just made in front of all those that are closest to you, and the Almighty God Himself. Grow together, love each other, fight for one another, and always make time for family. And you kiss your bride. I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, can I introduce for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Corey Bliss?
Yay!
All right, guys, we're going to do this a little less informal, but you guys can all go grab appetizers, the wedding party, and everybody involved is going to just take some pictures since we're all out here.